talking about Aaron, and not necessarily about him, but I think our listeners always wonder about how normal are we? You were in a relationship, you became single. How does someone who is like an average guy, like Cat, like Big Cat, how does he approach someone like you? Now, obviously, you're in a relationship, so, but someone like famous like you, that's this powerhouse, beautiful mm-hmm. woman, are you someone, A, that if you're at a bar or you want someone to walk up to you, mm-hmm. send you a drink, send you a note, email, DM? Yeah. Tell me about that process. If you were single, of course. Yeah,
well, I mean, I'd probably just go up and say hi. But I think, you know, I remember going to the ESPYs a long, long time ago and being afraid to go, not because I had a crush on anyone, but going up and saying hi to anybody. I'm like, God, I'm so scared. Like, they probably don't know who I am, you know. Like, they, you know, in the early days, they might not have. I don't know. But, you know, I got enough ovaries up to go over and say hi to some people. And I was like, okay, yeah, that's not so bad. And then finally you reach the point where you're like, they probably know who I am. Mm-hmm. And if I just go up to them and say, hey, I'm a big fan, nice to meet you, and walk away, like, I approach them in the way I'd want to be approached. So,
and that's your way of flirting?
No, that's just like meeting people.
Yeah, yeah. But like, if you had a crush on him. Yeah.
If I had a crush on someone.
How would you approach it? That's my question.
With total fear and just no belief that I had a chance, probably.
No. Drive a race car over 200 miles an hour.
I mean, I met Aaron a long time ago.
Yeah. Tell
so
us about that.
I don't have a 20-year-old history of a signed autographed picture like you do of J-Lo, but we met in 2012. So we met at the ESPYs. I remember it was like some after party, and I was like, oh, we're at the bar getting a drink, and oh, hey, and we started talking, and he was like throwing some movie lines. I'm like, this guy's really funny. And we kind of randomly kept in touch from that point on, and that's it. Like,
and how did it reconnect?
It was through that randomly kept in touch. We'd see each other at the ESPYs. I saw him in Tahoe one year at the golf tournament. Mm-hmm. Just random things and random reach outs. So it was kind of like he reached out, and I didn't. I didn't just sort of go, okay, great, nice, good to hear from you, hope you're well. It was like, how are you? Yeah. And then I was like, oh my God, we might have some things in common.
Wow. You guys make a great, great couple. And we're big fans of Aaron.
Well, I'm not.
Speak for myself.
I'm being truthful here. I'm a big fan of you, Danica, but I mean, I'm a Bears fan. I don't like Aaron Rodgers.
Oh, that's right.
Destroys my life, like, every single year.
So you just don't like him because he makes your life difficult. It's not that you don't like him.
Is it not?
Fair.
It's
fair.
A pretty good reason.
It's a twisted respect. It's okay.
Oh no, I've been very, very complimentary of him. Like, I do a lot of Aaron Rodgers is the best quarterback in the NFL, but I hate his fucking guts. Like, I do a lot of that.
That's fair. That's fair. That's fair.
Do you ever, and this is a question for both of you, being in a relationship with another famous person, does it ever bother you when, like, the littlest thing gets blown up in the press, or, you know, you're out in public and, like, for example, the Bucks fan who bought you a drink.
Oh, God. Do you want to know that story?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, here's the story. So I had said maybe within a week before, I never drink at games, at sporting events, and I never drink at concerts. I just don't. Like, I don't know. I've never been drunk. I maybe have had a drink before, but I've never been drunk at either one. Mm-hmm. And it's just not my thing, especially sporting events. I'm like, I'm an athlete. Like, it's just not appropriate, you know? So we're sitting in the front row, and everybody has a drink. Everybody has a drink at their feet.
Yeah.
And I see all these pictures of other celebrities that go to games, and they got they're chugging and getting cheered for. And I'm like, it's not that big of a deal. I'm 37. I can have a drink if I want. So I had one glass of wine early in the game. And then so the second half comes, and we all get back out there. And the guy behind was helpful because the waitress came to him because they can't – there's two rows. So – the waitress was behind the second row, and he's like, do you want anything? I'm like, actually, yeah. So that was in the first quarter. And then so I gave her like $20. Look, I didn't know they were free in the front row, but I didn't want to be a jerk anyway. So I just was like, oh, yeah, just keep the 20. And so then I was like, so then I'm sitting there at the second half, and I'm done, right? Like, I don't want any more. I was like, oh, that was fine, you know, but we're going to leave soon and the game, you know. And there's a 2-hour drive home. And so I'm like, no, I don't want one. And so he goes, I'm going to get you one anyway. So the waitress comes back with it. He hands it to me. And now, of course, I don't want to be a jerk. So I get my 20 out again. And I'm like, here you go. Give it to her. Because just because I don't want it doesn't mean she didn't have to go get it.
Right.
And so I took it. And I looked at the girl next to me because she didn't want hers either. But he got one for her, too. And I cheers her. We had a sip. And I put it between my feet. And that was it.
So the money, I can't even remember. When you tried to pay, they waved it off because it was all free. Right?
Oh, she took it.
Oh, she took it. Okay. So you're just really good tipper. Good tipper. Yeah, but see, that's the perfect example. Those little things
become huge things. Yes, when little things get blown out of proportion, it's annoying because it's impossible for it to not affect your psyche a little.
Yep.
Well, I missed the punchline. What was the story?
So the guy, like, it was basically like, oh, like some other guy is buying Danica Patrick drinks while she's sitting next to... guy who can't chug a beer. What did we say his nickname was?
This was before that.
Got it.
Yeah. Aaron.
Yeah, Aaron, yeah.
It looked like he was buying a beer or buying a drink for me, and Aaron's just kind of sitting there watching
Aaron
the game.
Aaron was getting cucked, to put it simply. go ahead. You were going to get to a big point there. Like, that thing would drive me nuts if those little things.
Well, because it's just stupid, and you know, people just love to... look, those kinds of headlines are fun for people to read, and... You know, it's whatever. I don't know how you feel, but it's not possible for it to not affect you at all.
Right.
Even if it's just 1%, you're like, that was stupid.
That's annoying.
Because I was pissed I was actually mad because I'm like, I never drink at games. And there it is. You know, like I had won and now he thinks I want a second, you know.
Right.
And so I was like, oh, there it is.
Right.
Just
and wait,
showing
so
why
if the
I don't
drinks
do
were free, he was doing that like lame joke that people do at like an open bar, like drinks on me. That's even worse by that guy.
God, you're right.
You're sitting it straight. Yeah.
Now I'm angry.
Yeah, now I'm angry because that joke sucks.
He was actually really funny. He's a really funny guy. Okay. He was really nice. He was friends with the people sitting to the right of us.
Okay.
So they've been at any game that we've been at.
Yeah.
So he's a really funny
guy.
That
would drive me nuts.
His commentary during the games is great. It's fun. But he was a lively guy that just wanted everyone to have a good time.
Yeah.